Okay, students. So today, from section 18.5 from the unit 18, that is pollution of air and water. Okay, on the last class, I discussed a very important topic: what is greenhouse effect and what is global warming, and what are the causes of global warming, etc. This is a very important with the respect of your exam. Now, the next part is the in search of remedy. Okay, in search of remedy. So section 18.5. So Shashikant project already given. Okay, in search of remedy of air pollution. Now I am reading from that part. So at first beginning, you can see that there is a picture given that Delhi Transport Corporation, world's largest eco-friendly CNG bus services. Now, CNG, already you come to know about this CNG, it is also called cleaner fuel. Cleaner fuel, why? Because they are producing less amount of carbon dioxide in the air. For this reason, it is called as cleaner fuel. Now, the next part, just reading from that, there are many success stories in our fight against air pollution. A few years ago, Delhi was one of the most polluted cities in the world. It was being choked by fumes released from automobiles running on diesel and petrol. A decision was taken to switch to fuel like CNG and unleaded petrol. And unleaded petrol is the refined one. These measures have resulted in a cleaner air for the city. Already, one steps were taken by the running government of Delhi is that odd and even car number. This is also one steps and ideas. And you might know about some other examples from your area regarding reduction of air pollution. Share these with your friends. Now, nowadays, you can see that the when the paddy leaves are cutted through the machine, and it is one project is now going on, that is, do not burn the straw, that is the cutting straw, which is kept on the field, at it is producing air pollution and at the same time is making a great trouble for the bio microorganism present on the soil. Okay, so that is two time, it is also a project. Now in Bengali it is calling in that name, khor poraben na sasya uparjon korun. It is an, you can see such kind of tagline which is running by the present government, and it is in the block level who is spreading such kind of ideas, because the straw is used in very different packaging industries or some other purposes. Nowadays the fiber from the straws are also deducted and extracted, and it is producing some using in the with the cotton or with the other chemicals to produce the dress materials or etc. Now, this is one also remedy for air pollution. Now, they are basically doing it due to their lack of knowledge, because they don't know about the bio microorganism, the microorganism present in the soil, and also the air pollution. So, this is an unique idea. Next one is that another one is the lack of vigilance by the committee or by the agency, which are also to keep in good condition the precipitator. That is, you can see the chimneys which are on the industries, they used one type of catalytic precipitator. These precipitator are for the deposition of the carbon particles, the sulfur particles which is producing, and also the metal particles also using a high electrostatic field. Now, if this is assumed to be a chimney, there is a high electrostatic voltage is applied, that is, they get polarized because they having some kind of particles. One may be positively charged and it is another might be negatively charged. So when a high electric field is applied through a region, then they get polarized with another one electrodes, and they will get deposited. Okay. So this is the role of the catalytic precipitator. This is also the lack of vigilance. So this should be vigilized. The vigilance committee should be aware on that matter. Okay. The quality of air at various locations are monitored regularly by government and other agencies. We can use these data to generate awareness about the air pollution among friends and neighbor. There is a need to switch over to alternate fuels instead of fossil fuels in our energy requirement. Now, do you know about any alternate power source? Do you know about any alternate power source? Tell me about this. What are the alternate power source? Waiting for your answer. Solar, wind energy. Okay, very good example. Solar, wind. Then wind energy, hydropower. Now the solar energy were in the topmost region, that is in the hilly region. There the solar energy can be used because it is very much trouble for the distribution system. So there the source of energy is the solar energy, and another one is the hydropower. Okay. Now next one is the another one alternate source, that is nuclear energy. But the nuclear power plant should be controlled in very strict manner. But nuclear power energy is also an alternate source. Okay. In which states of India the nuclear power plant is already established? Biofuels, hydrogen. Yes, these are also alternate fuel. Hydrogen, now biofuels or hydrogen. Hydrogen engine are also used. Basically, we have to produce the fire. Now, in whatever might be the source, we have to produce the power. In which states of India the already the energy, that is nuclear power plant, is established? Do you know? Okay. In the state of Tamil Nadu and Karnataka, they are showing the pathway for India. Okay. Next one is that activity 18.4 is that you have various options of commuting to your school, such as walking, going by bicycle, traveling by bus or other public transport. Using a car individually, traveling by a carpool. Discuss in your class the impact of each of these options on the quality of air. So, as we are become independent, so we are using the private cars. Okay, but there is a transport system, that is the rail system is there, the bus system is there. Okay, but people are using such private cars by avoiding such system, and at the same time they are becoming the responsible for the air pollution. Now, small contribution on our part can make a huge difference in the state of the environment. We can plant trees and nurture the ones already present in the neighborhood. Okay. We can nurture the plants because plants absorb the gases, basically carbon dioxide during photosynthesis. And by this way, the amount of carbon dioxide can release. And at the same time, we will get rid of the greenhouse gases, that is the what is called as the global warming. Do you know that when Vana Mahotsav was, lakhs of trees are planted in July every year? Vana Mahotsav is a project also. Next one, in the next page, in page number 245, and Paheli once happened to go to an area where some people were burning dry leaves. They started coughing because the entire area was full of smoke. Paheli thought it would be a better option to put them in a compost pit rather than burning. What do you think? So it is a better idea that we should not burn the compost, the plants, the dry leaves of the plants. It should be better that it should use the compost, because as it is organic material, it is decomposable. And it ultimately mixed up with the soil, okay, and also increases the soil quality. So these are some remedies from air pollution. So from industrial, from automobiles, and also another one that is increasing the forest areas, nurturing the forest, etc. is the ideas, and also use the alternate power source. These are the ideas for get relief of air pollution to somehow extent. Any problem in that portion? Problem 18.5. Next is the new topic, that is water pollution. So already we come to know about pollutants. Now next topic is water pollution. Now what are pollutants? Pollutants, those substances are responsible for the pollution of water, is called as water pollution. Now, water pollution, the water pollutants are basically producing from human activities. All are human activities, but human activities, one. Number two, agricultural field or agriculture. Number three, industrial. Okay, so human activities, agricultural field, industrial field, from where the different kinds of waste are producing, and it ultimately mixed up with the water system. It might be with the pond, it might be with the lake, it might be with the river, and ultimately they are going to the sea and producing a hazardous life towards the aquatic or marine life. Okay. So, what are air pollutants? Now look at this. In class 7, you have learned that water is a precious resource. Think and list the various activities in which we need water. Okay. We saw that water is becoming scarce due to increase in population. Industries and agricultural activity. You have also studied how water becomes dirty. Now, all the water using, that is in the industrial field, that is in our daily life, these are consumable water or drinkable water. Okay, so we are destroying our future in that way. You have also studied how water become dirty after we use it for washing clothes, bathing, etc. Now, washing clothes, we use detergents. Now, these detergents are basically one chemicals. These are sulfonic acid or carboxylic acid. Now, sulfonic acid, these are also one pollutants, but it is better to use soap, because soap, the soap using the compounds or the chemical which is less harmful, but the detergents, the sulfonic acid group is dangerous for the water. It is also an air pollutants, sorry, the water pollutants, and some materials to the water which spoil the quality and change its smell and color. Okay, so change its smell and color. One detergent mixed with water, then its color and also the smell is also changed. And if any human feces are mixed up with water or which is decomposing in water, its smell also change. In that way, water becoming polluted. Whenever harmful substances such as sewage, what is sewage? What is sewage? Already in class 7, you have learnt about sewage. Now, what is sewage? The sewage is the are the product substance of the pollution, are by the product substances of the pollution. Sewage is the dirt materials or decomposable materials which is also called contaminants. Okay, this is sewage, that is the bad chemicals, the human activities, that is the peels of the vegetables, etc., human feces, these are also called the sewage. Next one is the okay. Next one is coming to section activity 18.5. Try to collect sample of water from a tap, pond, river, well, and lake. Pour each into separate glass container. Compare these for smell, acidity, and color. Complete the following table. Now, tap water. So basically, it is clean water which is taken up. So, the smell, this is smellless. Acidity, it is normal water. Acidity is not changed. That the pH of the soil of the water is 7. So, the acidity means it is detected by the pH, that is the power of hydrogen atom. What is the full form? That is power of hydrogen atom. Okay, and the color, it is colorless. Pond water. Now, in pond water, the smell, it might not having any smell, but the acidity, it might be changed from the pH 7. Now, how to detect the acidity? You can use the indicator or one machine is used, one instrument. This instrument is also called pH meter. What is pH meter? It is used to detect the pH of any medium. Now, in that pH meter, there is a dais where we will keep the beaker with the filled with water, and there is a glass rod. Okay, this glass rod, and there is a board. There is an electronic board here. So, this is, there is a stand behind it. There is a stand and there is a clamp. Now, through the clamp, the pH meter is dipped on the water, and the reading we will get from this electronic device, this electronic display board. It will detect the pH of the solution. Now, pond water, their pH might be changed and it might be greater than 7, that is to somehow basic, the pond water. Next one, color. Now, in the villages, you can see in the summer season, the water, the color of the pond water becomes somehow greenish. It is due to some algae or fungus which is grown on the water. It is basically held in the summer season or might be in the rainy season also. Okay, next is that color. It may be some different, okay, some greenish, or sometime it becomes the muddy color, okay, brown color. Next one is the river water. River water, the smell, the river water smell is as it is naturally flowing, and if does not have having any contaminants, then it will be smellless. Okay, the acidity here is acidic, as river water flowing, the natural water that is by the source, that is from the ice melts, okay, and also from the rain water, it is basically a little bit acidic. Next one is the color. It is also colorless, but sometime it may be colored. Next one, it depends on the sample we take. Okay, if we collect the water from different sources, then it will be depends on the color. But I am giving you a general idea about this. Next one, well water. It is basically smellless, acidity it is normal, and the color no color or colorless. Lake water. Lake water having smellless and acidity is greater than 7 or nearly to 7, that is normal water, and the color may be different. Okay. Next is that section 18.7. Already one post is there from Trijit. Tap water clear, pond water brown muddy, river water greenish. I think river water is not greenish. Well water brownish, it's not brownish. Lake water clear. Okay, it depends on the sample, because it is on you. Okay, you will collect the sample from different source. Okay, next one. How does water get polluted? A case study. Okay, now how does water get polluted? Now there is on the, it is a project on river Ganges. Now what are the areas through which the water river Ganges are flowing? Now from starting from the hilly region, they are the most of the important cities and also populated cities, and also which is rich in industry. These cities are besides the river Ganges. Okay, so the wastes from these cities are ultimately mixed up with the water, that is the river Ganges. In that way it becomes polluted. Okay, so millions of people depend it on their daily needs and livelihood. Okay, now it's found that one of the 10 most endangered river in the world, the population level at these pollution level have been rising for many years. We have reached this stage because the towns and the cities through which the river flows throw large quantities of garbages, untreated sewage, dead bodies and many other harmful things directly into the river. In fact, the river is dead at many places where the pollution levels are so high that aquatic life cannot survive. Okay, so today we will end at that level, that what are the reason behind the pollution of river Ganges. Okay, next day we will start from Ganga Action Plan, which is an idea, okay, and also a case study. Any problem up to this? Okay.